lot of the struggles I see in my practice with just everyday people when it comes to weight loss is they can't wrap their head around this, oh, my Apple Watch or this says this and my Garmin says I'm burning this much and I'm eating this many calories and I'm just not losing weight.
So this is I looked at my watch, it told me I burned 700 calories, but somehow I'm not losing weight.
The reason I don't love that approach is because I see the mental stress that causes and how disheartened they get with the whole process. I had a gentleman come in and he said, man, I've been doing this. You know, I've got this charity boxing event. I really want to be in good shape for it. He's super motivated. All his friends are behind. He goes, man, I'm like, I can't figure out how to lose weight. I'm only eating 2,800 calories. And this is a big gentleman, fairly inactive. I said, what are you doing? He goes, oh, I'm in the garden. I'm doing gardening. And then I'm on the push bike for 30 minutes. My smart device is telling me I need 2,800 calories in a deficit. And I was kind of had to break it to him and go, oh man, like I have professional athletes who want to lose more weight than you. And we don't even go, like, I wouldn't go into a 2,800 calorie. They got to go way less than that to lose weight.
Yeah.
And they're doing five times as much activity as what you're doing. So you need to take that with a grain of salt. There's equations where you can go, okay, we've got this baseline number. I punched in my body weight times 40. I need to account for the activity that I'm doing, let's times it by 1.4 or 1.6, whatever. The best way and the safest way to figure out if you're in that deficit, put it to practice, control as many things as you can control in the calories outside, as well as the calories in the food. And then if you do that consistently and you lose the weight, you're in the deficit.